Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the final concert of the Swingin' Affair. I hope you've enjoyed the weekend. I certainly have.
Yes!
The musical things have just been spectacular, even better than I could have possibly hoped for. And I'm so glad you were all here to share it with us. This final concert tonight is something that's very, very special to us. And, you know, as you know, we lost Bob Florence about a year ago. And, you know, there's not a Bob Florence ghost band. There's not a Bob Florence band that's going to continue. But as you know, the limited edition came together and did a special tribute last year at Catalina's. And then did a recording to kind of serve as a final recording, which is available, and just out, as a matter of fact, and available. But we asked if we could do a special tribute and have the band together here at the festival, because it was something that was important to us, and we knew it would be important to all of you as well. So first of all, I want to thank Evie Florence and the Bob Florence family for allowing us to be here. Festivals, and was always an inspiration, always somebody that you could turn to and talk to about with, you know, for me personally, with different things related to the events that we were doing. And so tonight is, again, a very special night where we have an opportunity to hear one more time the music of Bob Florence, and it's my great pleasure to introduce for the final time at our event, one of our events, the Bob Florence Limited Edition.
Decided not to have a piano player there because nobody could really replace Bob, right? So, but he did intend for his music to have a piano part. So, I'm sure you understand we have Andy Langham here on the piano. Yeah. That one you just heard was from the new album. The new album just out. In fact, it won't be out until the next month, I believe, July. And is that Flag Day? Is it July or June?
June.
So June 14th is coming out, but we do have copies of it here. It's called Legendary, and I'm sure you'll all want to get a copy of it. We're very proud of it because we spent a lot of hours doing it, a labor of love, as you can see, and we really enjoy it. enjoy the music ourselves, playing all new things and fresh, more or less off the press. You heard Ron Stout on the trumpet. Bob Efford played the baritone saxophone. Guitar was Steve Gregory. Well, we're going to do this kind of in chronological order a little bit. Take some of the older things of Bob's and work up more into the present, although we did start with the present. Take the A Train, of course, was Duke Ellington's composition that Bob had a new slant on. That's what we just played. But one of the earliest pieces that we always like to play and everybody likes to hear was dedicated to a disc jockey at K-Jazz. And at that time it was KBCA, I think.
Yes.
Anybody remembers that? But that's Chuck Niles. And you probably have heard this before. If you ever get tired of hearing Bebop Charlie.
Thank you.
like to continue. We've got a lot of music, so very little talking, a lot of music. This next one is from the Concerts by the Sea album. This one's called I'll Remember.
Thank you.
union.
Yeah, just start there.
Anyway, we're kind of changing up who talks in between tunes because we all kind of have our feelings and, at stake here. And I just want to say that it was really a pleasure being asked by Mr. Florence a few years ago to sub on the band for a while, and then I kind of wormed my way into the band after a while. But it's really been a pleasure to be here with Bob's band. It's just beautiful music to play. We're going to do this old kind of, I think it was on his first album. It was on a street he used to live on in the valley. Is that right?
Yeah.
And I don't know if you never have the first album you ever had. I think this is where it's from. And we're going to hear, and we're going to play for you now, Willowcrest. Thank you.
this next arrangement we're going to do, I personally think is one of the prettiest, well, there's a lot of pretty things to be written, but this is definitely one of them. And, when we played the memorial, I was affected playing my part, and listening to Charlie play, and tears were running down my eyes. It was just beautiful. This is features two trombone players, Charlie Loper and Bob McChesney, and this is one of Bob's great charts on Chelsea Bridge.
Thank you. Thank you.
Charlie Roper and Bob McChesney. I wanted to mention something about that too. That was, you heard at the beginning especially, all the lovely clarinets, right? Six clarinets. How often do you hear that? That's what it's a standing joke. Everybody says they're all squeaking in their case. But Bob loved the clarinets, yeah. And he loved to write for clarinets, and that's one of the things, and especially Don and I love that about his music, and he loved the clarinets right. And so forth. There's some places in that thing that's right below Charlie Roper when he has the melody there that they intertwine and conflict in such a way that it's really kind of unnerving. You have to be sure of yourself to be able to play the part and stick to it. And I mentioned that to Bob one time, and he said something that I've used the line so many times after. He says, it only hurts for a few seconds. So I'm going to have Tom introduce the next selection.
Kim has me do that because it features Kim and Don. This is a very special original composition of Bob's, and this is dedicated to and written about the one and only Evelyn Florence, who's sitting right over here. We'd like to play this. Again, this features Kim and Don. This is called Evelyn, Queen of the Racquet Club. Yeah. Thank you.
Play one more tune before a very short intermission, and I guess the reason I was asked to say something about this chart, like all of my Bob, like all the Bob Florence charts, it's one of my favorites. They're all my favorites. But there's a recording of this, and the drum part that Bob created, and the realization that the late great Nick Ciroli crafted really set the bar for what a big band drummer can, should, and could be. So for your listening and dancing pleasure, here is Carmelo's By the Freeway. Thank you.
Thank you.
that's Peter Erskine, incidentally. We're going to try to keep this brief because we've got probably too much music. But I need to introduce this band of brilliant players playing this fantastic music. So let me start with the trumpets. This end, Steve Hofstede. Again, Peter Erskine on drums. Craig Henry. Steve Gregory on guitar. And Andy Lamb on piano. We'd like to continue now. This is one of our favorites, and one of yours. They're all favorites of ours, actually. This is Laura. I'm just in my state.
I wanted to bring this up. I had half a dozen people come up and say, what is that? You know, this is a contra bass clarinet in E flat, or it's also called a contra alto clarinet. And Bob would like to use this in line for it.
That takes care of that.
The next tune we're going to play was inspired by another DJ at our local jazz station. And as you remember, Chuck Niles was the first one. This one, Bob was in doing an interview with Helen Borgers, and it was her birthday, and it was one of the old birthdays. I think it was probably the 40th, because it's been in the book for a while. And actually, this tune is on the new album as well. But she was feeling quite old, and Bob, you know, was inspired then to write a tune, and this next tune is called Geezerhood. And who I believe had just turned 40.
I thought it was for the whole band.
Lead us off, Bob.
Thank you.
much too much music here, and it's kind of hard to eliminate anything, but I think that we can get away with playing this. This is kind of a long selection. And at one point, Bob did some writing and some work for Stan Kent, his Mediaphonic. Is that what we're doing? Oh, I thought we were going to do it.
Mandel.
I'm misinformed.
The two points.
One of Bob's favorite composers is Johnny Mandel, and Johnny loved the chart that Bob did on his Emily. It happens to be my favorite chart too, so we're going to play Emily.
Thank you. parts is parts.
We'll be right there. Remember what he was talking about before? Now.
As I was saying, before I was so rude to you, I changed the plan. At one point, Stan did some writing for me, Stan Kenton Diafonic, and being having an alumni kind of connection, he did a tour with the Mike Bax Big Band, featuring the alumni of Stan Kenton for several years. In fact, I have to admit, I was the one that suggested that he go along. And I didn't think that he would want to at first. But he said if he could go with his dear Emmy, he would do it. And so for many years, they did quite a few tours with us. And anyway, he wrote, to fit in with that, and some other things too, he wrote a piece. It's quite long, so that's why we were wondering whether we should do it. Is it okay? Do it.
Yeah.
Just wanted to check.
Yeah.
I don't know if anybody was falling over of exhaustion, like we are. But anyway, he liked to introduce this piece, and I'll always remember and never get tired of the way he introduced it. So I want to read it to you, just the way that he did it. And because Mike would always ask Bob to introduce this piece. So this is Bob's narrative. It is also part of his liner notes on the last limited edition recording, the one before the last one. Here's what he said. As a kid growing up, I used to sneak my radio under the bed covers and listen to a late night jazz show. The show was hosted by Gene Norman, who had a slightly pompous style of interviewing. One night, Stan Kenton was a live guest in the studio. To conclude the interview, Gene Norman asked Stan, "Well, Stan, where is jazz going from here?" Without hesitation, Stan answered, "Well, we're appearing in Cleveland on the 30th. I know many of you have heard that before, but it's a timeless thing, isn't it? Anyway, here's Bob's composition called Appearing in Cleveland.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Once again, the Bar Chorus Limited Edition. Thank you again to Heavy Chorus and the Bar Chorus family. Thank you all so much for being here this weekend. Have a safe trip home, and we'll see you all back in October. Good night.